Our Sacred Honor, a Luke Stone thriller, book 6, written by Jack Mars, narrated by Casey Kelly. Chapter 1. December 9th, 11:45 p.m. Lebanon time, 4:45 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Southern Lebanon. Praise God, the young man said. Praise him. Praise him. He took a long drag from his cigarette, his hand shaking as he reached to his mouth. He hadn't eaten in 12 hours. For the past 4 hours, the world around him had been entirely black. He was a truck driver, skilled at driving the biggest rigs, and he had driven this one across the border from Syria, then through the hilly Lebanese countryside, moving slow on winding roads, lights off the entire way. It was a dangerous drive. The sky was filled with drones, with helicopters, with spy planes, and with bombers, Russian, American, and Israeli. Any one of these could become interested in this truck. Any one of these could decide to destroy the truck and do so effortlessly. He drove the entire way, expecting that at any moment a missile would hit him without warning, rendering him a flaming skeleton sitting inside a burned-out steel relic. Now he had just pulled the truck up a long, narrow path and parked it under an awning. The awning, held up with wooden legs, was made to look from the sky like typical forest cover. In fact, the top of it was covered with dense brush. Its location was right where they said it would be. He turned the truck off, the engine farting and belching, black smoke pouring from a stack on the driver's side as the thing shut itself down. He opened the door to the cab and climbed down. As soon as he did so, a squad of heavily armed men materialized like ghosts, emerging from the surrounding woods. "Assalamu alaikum," the young truck driver said as they approached. "Wa alaika salam," the militia leader said. He was tall and burly, with a thick black beard and dark eyes. His face was hard. There was no compassion in it. He gestured at the truck. "Is this it?" The young man took another shaky drag from his cigarette. "No," he almost said. "Some other truck is it. This one is nothing." "Yes," he said instead. "You're late," the militia leader said. The young man shrugged. "You should have driven in that case." The leader stared at the truck. It looked like a typical tractor trailer, perhaps something carrying lumber or furniture or foodstuffs, but it wasn't. The militiamen went right to work on it, two climbing the back ladder to the top, two kneeling near the bottom. Each man had a battery-powered screwdriver. Moving quickly, they removed the screws one by one that held the tractor-trailer fiction together. Within moments, they pulled a large piece of aluminum sheet metal off the side. A moment later, they pulled a narrower sheet off the back. Then they were working on the other side, where the driver could no longer see them. He turned and looked out at the nighttime hillsides and forest. Across the darkness, he could see the lights of a village twinkling several miles away. Beautiful country. He was very glad to be here. His job was done. He was not a militiaman. He was a truck driver. They had paid him to go across the border and pick up this truck. He was also not from this region. He lived far to the north. He had no idea what arrangements these men had made for his return home. But he didn't care. Rid of the infernal machine he had just driven, he would gladly walk from here. Headlights were coming up the narrow, rutted road, a whole series of them. Seconds later, a line of three black Mercedes SUVs appeared. The doors opened in unison, and gunmen poured from each car. Each man carried a heavy rifle or machine gun. The rear door of the middle car opened last. A heavy-set man, with a salt-and-pepper beard and glasses, pulled himself from the SUV. He leaned on a knobby wooden stick and walked with a pronounced limp, the residue of a car bomb attempt on the man's life 2 years ago. The young driver recognized the man instantly. He was certainly the most famous man in Lebanon and well known throughout the world. His name was Abba Qassem, and he was the absolute leader of Hezbollah. His authority in matters of military operations, social programs, relations with foreign governments, crime and punishment, life and death, was unquestioned. His presence made the driver nervous. It came on suddenly like a stomach sickness. There were the nerves that came with meeting any celebrity, yes, but there was more to it than that. Kassem being here meant that this truck, whatever it might be, was important. Much more important than the driver had realized. Kassem hobbled to the truck driver, surrounded by his bodyguards, and gave him an awkward hug.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.